So my speech called, how we make it happen. Okay, so it's kind of short story of my life. What happened to me, I would say, 7 years ago. I'm Russian, so all my family back in Russia. How I got to the United States, I don't know. When USSR was broken down, and you know, we started seeing all the products, movies, TV shows from the United States. I mean, yeah, after that we started seeing it. Everybody was inspired by Hollywood. Everybody in my country wanted to go to the United States and see, is that true or not? I was one of those people. I've never forgot how I got in the United States my first time. So, you know, it was, you know, it's unforgettable experience. I was a second year student in my university, and I don't remember exactly how it happened, but I found out about a program that allows students to go to the United States and work during the summertime. I went to the company, I just did my research, went to the company, you know, find out about all the requirements, and there was two requirements. It's a written test and verbal test. So my next step on the way to the United States was to find a good teacher, English teacher. Even though I learned English in school, in high school, in the university, anyway, I was thinking about, you know, getting more, you know,
fluent.
Yeah, more fluent, thank you. So I found a teacher, said it and did it. After 1 year of hard learning process, I went to the company and took those tests. Next day, I came back to find out my results. And the recruiter told me that my participation in this program is uncertain. And I forgot to answer one question in my written test. So he told me, if you answer this correctly, you go to the United States. If not, I'm sorry. So, yeah, it's kind of, he just gave me the question. I didn't know the answer. I just took a guess and I got it right. So. Yeah, after a few months, there was a time to go to the embassy to get a visa. 10 hours of nervousness and waiting just paid out to get a visa. I'm the happiest person in the world. I couldn't believe how happy I am. So I got back home, shared my excitement with my parents and friends. Everything's great. After a few weeks, you know, everything got back to normal. And you know, I remember that day my father came back from home, happened back from work, and said to me, you know what, son, you're not going anywhere. I have no idea what happened to him. He just heard something, maybe he saw something that totally changed his mind. It took us, I think, 1 month to convince him to just to let me go. Because we told them there is a company exists for more than 5 years. We let them talk to the students who went to this, you know, to participate in this program and came back. And I even set up a phone call between the recruiter and my father, so he can learn more about the program, and it's not a fraud or something. So finally he said, okay, yeah, you can go. I think I had like 3 months before, you know, my departure. A few months, you know, passed by. It's time to go, you know, to the dean of my university and ask him to pass my exam in advance. Okay, I'm in dean's office, waiting for him. He went out. I tell him, you know what? I would like to pass my exam in advance. He just like, he asked me, why would you like to do that? Because I'm going to the United States, I'm very excited about it. Are you going to the United States because of, you know, this exchange program? I don't know, but I can represent my school in the United States. He told me, since you're not going from university, you cannot go. I cannot let you do this. I'm sorry. I was negotiating with him during the for 1 week, and couldn't convince him. And after that, I went to the rector. This guy, I talked to this guy for another week, but I finally convinced him to let me go, to let me do this. He was just concerned about, you know, me coming back in time, because in the past it was a couple of students who didn't get back in time. So I just, you know, during that week, I was coming back to him with new arguments in my defense. So finally he gave up and said, you know, read your petition one more time, go to the dean, and everything's gonna be okay. Great, I came back to the dean's office. He's not there. Where is he? He's in clinic. Okay, great, I'll be back tomorrow. Came back tomorrow. Where is he? He's in hospital. Okay. When he's coming back? He's coming back in, I don't know, next week. Great, came back next week. What happened? Where is Dean? Dean is dead.
Oh.
Yeah. So I was shocked. I was shocked. My paper wasn't signed yet. I couldn't start doing my, you know, my exams. But my rector finally signed all my papers and let me pass my exams. I passed my all exams in one day, and then the next day I just packed my bags and it was here into the airport. And I just want to finish the speech with you know, the words from, I think it's Indian poet, his name Allama Iqbal. It sounds like, "Oh ho, don't be afraid of this powerful gust of wind. They may